Hello, everybody, and thanks for welcoming me to the meeting. A lovely meeting. Long time since I've been up in Norfolk, but brilliant. It's nice to be back up here. Only 350 days to go to Christmas. That went quick, didn't it? Christmas. 2024, release the past, embrace your future. What does it mean? As Chris said earlier, PIN is a training company. A lot of what they do is mindset. I don't know why they leave mindset to the last piece of a night evening, but you know, I'll try and keep you awake. A lot of what people see is what they believe. The media, what they hear about schools and building, as people we've said tonight, is now the right time to buy a property. Oh no, don't do that. We've all heard that. There's a lot of stuff under the water. In fact, it's well known that icebergs are bigger under the water than they are above it. And that's a lot about what goes on in the world, in what we don't know and what we don't see about the news. It all comes from our conditioning. Who am I to help you? My name's Paul Wilson, I live in Sittingbourne and I'm in Kent. I've been investing in property since 1997. I owned a flat, which was a buy-to-let. I've been coaching since 2022. I specialise in mindset and systems within businesses, basically. I invest in buy-to-lets, HMOs, developments. In the Nottingham area was my original portfolio, which I've now sold. And then I'm going to restructure in a different area this year. And along with my wife, we are the hosts of Kempin. So we kind of know what goes on. Nothing happens without change. If we want different results, then act differently. To act differently, we need to think differently. I went off the page, didn't I? Oh, you know, I'm right. It's no good doing what you did yesterday and expecting a different result. It won't happen. To get a different result, we have to do a different thing. And it all comes down to think, feel, act. If we want a property business, we need to treat it like a business. There's a saying that someone once said, I can't remember who it was, but I will reference it, is if you treat it like a business, it will reward you like a business. If you treat it like a hobby, it will cost you like a hobby. And it's worth remembering, when you're adapting, when you're doing your property business, it's important to give it your utmost attention. And sometimes by having a default diary where everything is in that diary, doesn't matter what it is, get out of bed, get up in the morning, put it in the diary. Doesn't matter, eat breakfast, put it in diary. Knowledge is the precursor to change. Reason that is up there is because the first person you should invest in is you. That's what PIN is all about. It's not about these other training organisations that have carbon machines up the back. I've never ever seen one in my 3 years in PIN. The last point. Everyone wants to start things, but then there's enough people out there. If you want to learn about property, don't go down the local pub and talk to your mates or talk to the people that are doing completely different stuff, working in offices all day, don't believe in property. I've got a stepmother who doesn't believe in people owning their own businesses, which isn't very helpful when I go and see her. I just don't talk about it. So you've always got the start, the stop, and the continue button available to you to choose when you talk to, who you talk to, and when you start. This is one of Simon's courses. It's called Strategy Implementation Live. It is 3 days. I have no idea, and I will apologise now. I have no idea why this is in this twice. And I do explain it at the end. I will, at this point, I'll just say it's one of the best courses you'll go on. It's along with Accelerator. It's a three-day event that will scramble your brain silly. And I'll talk a little bit more at the end. It'll make a lot more sense at the end. Right, success will come from your own self-awareness, not what other people think of you, because that really doesn't matter. It doesn't give a damn what anyone thinks of you, because only you know what your situation is. Only you know how much money you have, where you want to invest, how you want to do it. What coaches do is give you accountability, help you strategize, help you get to where you want to be. But it's the accountability, because willpower alone won't do it. Unless you have the drive of Buddy, who, and gentleman over there, sorry, I forgot your name, but who are so passionate about what they do, so passionate about just doing property. You get up in the morning, you think, it's raining outside, it's snowing. Oh well, I'll turn over in bed. You're not going to be that person that gets up at 6 o'clock in the morning and does whatever you do between 6 and 6:15 and then start your 6:15 till 7 o'clock. It just won't do it. So what you change is up to you. You can drive that change. Become accountable. Mix in different circles. I referenced it before. If you drink down the pub with all of the unemployed, you might not go far, because you'll be talking to them about your property business and how you're getting it off the ground. Success comes from who you want to be, where you want to be. What we train is how to get there. And it's about vision, knowing what you want in 5-10 years, knowing what you want in 3 years. There's a lady within PIN, in fact, a lot of us do it. It's called 90-day planning. Knowing what you're going to do for the next 90 days, every 90 days. And you sit down every month and you go, you just add another 30 days on. So be clear about what you want. Be clear about the numbers. Be clear about the date when you want to achieve it by. Who you want to do it with. There's another slide that makes sense of what I just said there. Becoming your future self. In the past, psychology has focused on problems. We all know the media in this country like to knock people down. Nick Faldo, when he was at the top of his game in golf, they focused more on his divorce than when he won the Open. And how his ex-wife, his new girlfriend, threw a 9-iron through the roof of his Porsche. It was dominated by determination, where your past dictates who you are and what you're doing now. It doesn't give a damn what you were yesterday, what you were the day before, what you were. You can only change what you do in the next 10 seconds, the next day, the next week, the next year. If you continue looking at the past, I lost this, I did this, and your family around you. One of my coaches spoke to him, and he was scared of starting another business, because in 2013, he lost everything, and his wife held it against him. And reminds him every day that he lost their nest egg. Still. Dr. Benjamin Hardy, what a great author. Focus on you. Focus on what you want to be. Be connected. Go to places. If you like eating out, go to a nice restaurant. I don't really know the restaurants around here, but round our way we've got the Ivy. Nice restaurants. There's a lovely hotel up in where all the seals are. There's a famous chef up there, isn't there? That's got a hotel. That's it. Yeah, go to places like that. If you don't feel comfortable in your own surroundings, in your house, your flat, your apartment, haven't got room, which many of us don't. Go to Morstan Hall, sit in there and have a cup of coffee every morning. I'm sure you'll have a lovely outlook over the fields and everything, and you can relax and do work on your laptop. 2 hours, great way to spend a Sunday morning. Are we good at predicting the future? A lot of people predict the future by looking at the past. Recently, I worked from 2014 to 2021 as a project manager for a broadband company. They wanted to grow the business by 25% every year on year. They based their warehousing on what they did 3 months ago and wondered why they kept running out of materials. And they just couldn't understand it. If you base what you want to do in 3 years' time on what you've done 3 years ago, it doesn't matter. You could have been in prison 3 years ago. You're not going to do a lot there. You could have been anywhere. I was just speaking to the host of Cambridge Pen, and she's got property entrepreneur, so she's had to go tomorrow. She's got that tomorrow. And she said, you've done it. No, I'm going to do it in 3 years' time. The reason I'm going to do it in 3 years' time, property entrepreneur is very, very, very heavy on technical and immersive. And I've got a 14-year-old son. So I plan. And it's about not doing it, but planning when you're going to do it. Have the right mindset. We're scared. Don't want to do that, I might be successful. Don't want to do that, I might be a failure. What if I don't do it right? If you don't do it right, at least you did it. But if you don't do it at all, you'll get to a ripe old age and think, I wonder what would have happened if I did that. Could have been a millionaire. If you want to gain how far you've come forward, look at where you were 5 years ago, what you were doing. Soon you'll become aware in your own mind about how much change there is, how much you've achieved. People don't reward themselves, especially in England. We don't do the rah-rah of the United States. We don't do what Sweden do. They all of them celebrate small achievements. I noticed one thing tonight in this meeting. Nearly everybody that stood up and spoke, everyone got a clap. And that's great because no matter how big your achievement was, it's brilliant. Because you did it. You got your ass out of bed and made it happen. But sometimes it's hard to envisage that going forward. Sometimes there are days when we don't feel the feel. And it's those days when you look at your vision board. Make it connectable. Make it so you see it every day. Stick it on the fridge. I did that once, then I upset the wife. We see ourselves in the future. How many people see, oh, I'll take my pension. I'll just retire. They don't work out that they've actually, to take their pension, they've got to live to 120. Because otherwise, if they die at 90, they'll leave £80,000 to £90,000 in their pension. What could they do with it? Change that now. Don't get to that place. This is the book, Benjamin Hardy, Be Your Future Self Now. It's a fantastic book. It's on my listening. I like the audio book. While I'm driving, I can listen to it. As I said before, your past does not define you. How you define your future defines you today. Only you can answer that. Do you have a big, bright future pulling you forward? It's you need to put that in place. If you have trusted people in the family, tell them. Get them to be accountable. Get your best friend. Hold me accountable at this. I need to do this by next week. Accountability will make us move. Don't let your past dictate because it doesn't really matter. How many people in this room have got children? Me too. My son had an unfortunate incident last week, and he was scared that I would judge him and throw him out because of the things he'd done. Yet every parent in this room, I hope, I told my son, it doesn't matter, mate. You could murder someone. I'm not going to throw you out. I might be a little bit angry, depending on who it was, but you know, maybe not. But don't be judged, because those, it is that inside us. You have to be able to, don't be fearful, you know. You're letting your past dictate your future. My son was scared of, because of what he went through with his mother many years ago, being told that she'd get rid of him, that I would do that. And I'm now trying to help him understand that that isn't real world. A proper parent doesn't throw their children out. How can property create the future you want? I think we only have to look at the three speakers earlier on. Fantastic presentations. Very, very, very inspirational. Property can do it. Property can undo it. There are many, many people who do it wrong. Oh, I love this slide. I don't have enough money. We've all heard that one. Don't have enough time. How many people don't think they have enough time? The thing I always say to everybody, we all have exactly the same amount of time available. It's 24 hours in the day. How you divide it up and do what you want to do to achieve what you want to be and where you want to be, it's up to you. If you love your soaps, Coronation Street, Emmerdale, EastEnders, whatever, then that's 3 hours. Was that me or the soaps? I can't find deals in my area. London's too expensive, don't invest there. Problem is, in London, you'll get much better rewards. It's impossible to buy good deals in this market. If you can't buy good deals in this market, you never ever will. I don't know where to start. Doesn't matter, just start. Just start. Just watch Simon's podcast. It comes out, I think, every Tuesday, isn't it? Tuesday morning, I think. Just watch his podcast. Just watch stuff of Ben Hardy. Listen to what people say. I watched Steve Jobs, a program on him. Amazing what Steve Jobs did. Wasn't quite amazing how he treated some people, but to have the foresight to create Apple and what they did. I don't have the knowledge or the confidence. All of that, and I don't know, Chris, if you say this in the meetings, but all of that comes from PIN. PIN creates a society. I've done Mastermind. As Chris said, he's done Mastermind. And many of you in the room have done Mastermind. But we become a community, a family of people who can call on each other with each other's experiences to help each other, to not lose money, to not get taken for a ride. Which side of that line you want to sit is up to you. I know where I'd rather be. So if you've got the top three, you can get your future self. Usually the bottom three will look from the past. I'm never going to do that. I mentioned my stepmother before. She still invests in the stock market the way you used to do it 20 years ago, despite there being funds that will group some of the shares together and you can invest in that so you spread your risk. No. you know, she could do a lot more. People could do more if they change. But how many people in this room have got people in their families who hate change? I have. My daughter's one of them. And she's at university. Do we look at things as a cost?
You don't want to change any of that, do you?
That's not me, by the way. I know I've got... Yeah. I don't wear a vest. If we look at anything as a cost, then it'll put us off. I don't want to do that. It's going to cost me $3,000. If we look at an investment, a business investment, which is what property is, and if you do it as an investment, you'll get it right, you'll have what Buddy's got and what that gentleman over there with your lovely dog has got. George, thank you. I can't read your thing from there. My eyesight's not that great. High performers invest in themselves every day. And that's where I mentioned default diary. My wife's disabled and she needs to exercise in a swimming pool because she can't walk properly. So our default diary for this year, we've got to get rid of the Christmas bit where we've been laying in, but is to go back to get up at 6:30 in the morning, get ready, do a walk, get our son to school, go to the swimming pool, and then start work at 11 o'clock. Now, whether we go back home and in the office and start working at 11 o'clock in the office, or whether we go stay in the pub and have in the gym and have a small breakfast, healthy breakfast and a cup of tea, that's up to us. But we invest in ourselves by making sure we're healthy. Continually invest in yourself every single day. Do something different, do something learning. Whether it's a podcast, whether it's a book, whether it's... I hate reading. Between... Up until 3 years ago, I think I'd read 4 books in my life. I hated reading. I fell asleep at it. Now I've read about 44. But I've listened to them. Because when I'm driving and getting lost coming to pin meetings... That's all right, I've got to see Norwich Airport. How to become your future self now. Said it earlier on, be clear about what you want. Decide what you want. Actually spend time, and I'm talking 30 minutes, with yourself. What do I want in 3 years' time? Make that a clear thing that you want to do. Don't have reactive goals, but create goals. Create goals for you. Create goals that are going to mean something to you, that you're going to be passionate about, that you're going to achieve. I go to a mental health group every Tuesday and I help some guys there. One guy there I'm going to be helping. I just want to set him some goals. Make 3 cups of tea a day. Empty the bins once a week. Just stuff I know he's going to succeed. You know, in this room, make your challenging. Make them challenging. So you're going to work hard at them to get them. And make the stuff, the reward, good. If you make $50,000 on a property deal, then celebrate it. Go out for a meal or something with your family. Do something. Because then that pat on the back will give the encouragement to go forward. Raise your self-awareness and master your emotions. Become self-aware. Who are you mixing with? Who are you with? People knocking you for what you're doing? Get rid of all the past blame and excuses. There are no excuses to not do what you want to do. There may be reasons, but how you change those reasons is up to you. I love the way they put these words in this slide. The one determinant of getting results is your level of commitment. physically, emotionally, mentally. If you're not mentally in the right place, you're not going to achieve it. But you can get into the right place. You can. Every coachee that I coach, I have 15 minutes break beforehand to clear down either the previous first person or the previous thing I was doing. Because I might have been doing the accounts, which bores the hell out of me. But I've got to have a clear mind to go into the next session. Build a relationship with where you want to be. Go out to those places where you want to go. Not every day, but you know, go and feel what it's like. If you want to buy an Aston Martin, go and test drive one. What you do will create a purpose for you. It might also create, as we've seen in this room, I think there's two people with their daughters or sons with them. You know, you pass it down. They might be interested. They might not be interested in just getting it anyway, but you know. Be results orientated. Watch what you do, what your results. KPIs. I used to work for NatWest for 18 years. We had KPIs coming out of our ears. Key performance indicators, for those that don't know what it is. But those numbers, the one thing Simon's always said is if the numbers don't stack up, don't buy it. Don't buy it emotionally because you love it. It's a lovely property. If the numbers don't stack, they don't stack and they won't work. Make your commitment. Commitment or interested or business or hobby. One will cost you. The other one will treat you very well. There you go. Starts with you. I've said it before. Starts with your decision, where you want to go, what you want to do. And there's this meeting every single month. And there are very good people in this room that you can refer to, that you can come back to get success and change your life. But you have to be 100% committed. Otherwise, it will cost you money. I'm not going to say that again. I've said it. Just let you read that rather than me reading it. Some of these things are very powerful. Just have them around. I've got some in my office that are just in little frames. You just look up at them. How many have heard that? Your net worth is your net worth. The people you are with, you don't know. There might be someone with £1 million in the bank in here that might want to do a joint venture. But unless you do what Chris said and network with three different people and meet three different people, you won't ever meet that person. How many people know Dan Hill's story? Dan Hill met his first investor at a PIM meeting. That investor only ever went to one PIM meeting. And at that meeting, he met Dan Hill. Dan found out how much money he had. They went out for lunch, dinner, all this lot. Create a relationship with each other. And now Dan Hill's got a £20 million portfolio because of it. All used with these investors' money. That's what PIN is. It's a great network to belong to. Great network to be in. And it's what I enjoy about PIN itself. It's different to other organisations. What is self-discipline? It's the ability to get done what needs to be done even when no one is watching or making you do it. As I say, it's what makes you get out of bed and do what you need to do. It's no good thinking, oh, it's my business. I'll watch the morning news or Loose Women or whatever it is that's on at lunchtime. These are Simon's 6 steps to create high discipline, self-discipline. Optimise your body and mind and body. One of my aims this year is to lose 3 stone. When we're tired, we are attacked by ideas conquered long ago and try and reinvent the wheel. Don't need to reinvent the wheel. There's over 1,500 people been through Mastermind, haven't they? About that, haven't they? They've all done something different. Stuart Scott has got his, you know, high-end HMOs. Being tired makes you want to quit. Which is why it's important to get decent sleep. How many people in the room realise the importance of sleep? There are studies in it. Absolute studies. My son won't agree, but you know. You want to be at the top of your game, make sure you get enough sleep, but make sure that when you're awake, you optimise it to your left. Action steps, sleep, eat healthily, drink a lot of water, yoga, mindfulness, and sport. It is about health. It's about healthy living in general. Get really excited about your future self. Look at yourself in the mirror, smile, go, yes! As I said earlier on, build your self-esteem. Achieving lots of little things. You don't have to set your goal. If you set your goal at earning £1 million this year, and you're at the start of your journey, you're going to fail. If you set yourself at doing your first property within 3 months, you'll probably achieve it. Track your success. Celebrate good each day. I've already said that. Create an affirmations list. Tick things off. You hear about people being list people. I used to hate that saying, are you a list person? But unless you have a list, you don't know what you achieve. You lose track of it. Focus on what can move you forward and eliminate what distracts you. So something my wife and I are talking to each other about all day, every day. Is it moving us forward? Are we spending this 50 quid and is it moving us forward or is it costing us money? It's not my work, it's my passion. George said that earlier on. It's passion. He loves it. Absolutely adores it. And so does Buddy.
It is work,
but it is work, but it gets you out of bed in the morning, doesn't it? Focus on something you care passionately about. Whether it's your family, whether it's your children, whether it's just you don't want to be in an office, don't want to be in the job that you're in now. Use property to create a life that will allow you to have your passion. Helping others, giving back. That's why I'm go out Tuesday nights and help people. Build that discipline into your identity. Three layers of behaviour change, outcomes, processes, identity. Processes, I said earlier on, I teach systems. Processes and systems, very, very similar. Have it written down, have contacts. Know where you are, know when you last spoke to them, know who you're going to speak to. Have everyone in a contacts list. Be, do, have. You'll come across that. If you look at psychological books, Dr. Benjamin Hardy, and many, many others will have, be, do, have. You set the rules that you live by. There you go. I'll always be in bed by 10:30. That's one of mine this year. I'm going to fail tonight since it's going to take me nearly 3 hours to get home. So. I complete big steps one step at a time. That's about how do you eat an elephant. You can't do it in one sitting, so just one bit at a time. I only have alcohol on special occasions. It amazes me today how many young people don't drink. It amazes me, because there's, when I, in the back in the 80s, the culture in London, the world's drinking. You know, working, drinking and everything. It's amazing how much it's changed. I network to build connections weekly. Have a reason to come to this meeting. Have a reason to go to the Cambridgeshire meeting. Don't come to the meeting just because you know, oh, it's a night out, isn't it? I'm not sitting in front of the telly. Come here and go, oh, I'd like to meet someone who's a landlord or someone who's a letting agent or someone. Have a reason and go out a coffee with them at the weekend. Or if you work full-time property, just get their number and make an appointment. Give yourself a lazy day. Give yourself a day that is about you, about investing in just enjoying what you did, or just working out what you did. And be authentic all the time. Consistency is what will get you the results. Without consistency, you will find flaws and holes. I've said this. Future self, coach, mentor, join Mastermind. I wouldn't have done what I've achieved without Mastermind. Set penalties for not doing it. Believe me, if you do Mastermind, do it. Because just paying for it and not turning up or not, I've seen people do it, they'll buy it and do it the virtual way. And I go, I'm on Mastermind. But you'll never see them, or they'll see them once a month out of four meetings. And they won't do all of the different bits. And they'll miss out on so much and then never achieve anything. And they'll go, that course that Simon does, it's rubbish. Don't think, just do it. What's coming up next? Just do it. You don't even have to. No, it's not actually. So, in summary, optimize your mind and body. Become super excited about who you are becoming. Focus on something you care passionately about. Build discipline into your identity. Create an unbreakable set of rules to live by and trap yourself into being consistent. And then you will have success. The right mindset. Gains right knowledge, specialist knowledge, finds right guidance and support. Very hard to be successful on your own. That's why we say about joint ventures and meeting people and having a team. You can't do everything. You're not allowed to start with, you need a solicitor, but that solicitor is your part of your team. All Mastermind delegates commit and invest in themselves, which is how we get the right specialist knowledge, gain the right support, build our confidence. Use coaches as a sounding board to check deals out, and we keep them on track. The number one determinant of getting results is your level of commitment. Speed of implementation, goes back to when's the right time. It's now, because if you didn't do it yesterday, it's now. And you need to be decisive. And be ready for that one property in your area that comes along that nobody else sees and you get it. Strategy implementation live again, there's the dates. I think there's a special offer on here with the silver ticket, save £300 using the promo code, which will be on the QR code. And there's £1,000 saving on the platinum tickets. They start from £497 plus the VAT. As with everything, I don't know if it's on there, is it? I'll come back. No, I'll go back. As with everything, it's not on there, but it will be. Strategy implementation live. If you don't like it and it's not for you, every single one of his courses comes with 100% money back guarantee. If it's not for you, just give all the stuff back, you get your money back. I've seen it done. Well, no, I've never seen it done. I've seen it be offered, but I've never ever known anyone. Do you know anyone that's done it? No. So yeah, if you're available on those dates, and it's a terrific, whether you go virtual, in the room's much better, obviously. But yeah, whether you go virtual, that's up to you. But all your accommodations included, if you go in person, and take the Monday off, because you'll need it, because your brain will be scarce. But you'll meet some great people, and you might meet a joint venture, and you might meet your business partner, and you might meet someone who's doing exactly what you want to do, and they've done it, and they've got success, and they can help you. 51, that's yours. That's your bit. Because I've got my own pen. Sorry about that. No, oh, sorry.
Quite a lot. Thank you for listening, everybody.
So, yeah, thanks, Paul. That was so hopefully you got some inspiration, a few nuggets to take away.